president of PASHA in Bolo Bhi Civil Society Organization is a true inspiration for all women. Her only aim, to empower communities through information and communication technologies. Mir Muhammad Ali Khan, founder of investment bank in USA, first Muslim and Pakistani who owns an investment bank at the Wall Street. Mr. Rehman Allawala, at young age of 13, started his first company, Pakistan Computers, and now owns many multinational companies. Who are these people? Are they someone who are born with golden spoons in their mouth? Well, they're just ordinary people with an extraordinary idea that changed their lives. So ladies and gentlemen, I am Momina Khan, your host for today, and I welcome you all to this most awaited seminar on entrepreneurship by Mr. Asad Umar. Mr. Asad Umar, the former CEO of Engro Corporation. His 27 years of experience as business analyst at Engro became in 1985 when the company was still a subsidiary of ExxonMobil, the global oil giant. In 1997, he was appointed as the first CEO of Engro Polymer and Chemicals. And ladies and gentlemen, after being elected as the president of and CEO of Engro Corporation in January 2004, he transformed this company from a mere chemical company to a giant conglomerate. And not to miss out, ladies and gentlemen, that was his idea that Engro could diversify into dairy and food business, which is now earning huge profits. And last but not the least, he was awarded the highest civilian award, Sitara Imtiaz, in 2010. So ladies and gentlemen, without further delay, I would like Sir, Mr. Asad Umar, to welcome on the stage. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum. मुझे ये entrepreneurship के ऊपर मैंने इतने lecture दिए हैं कि उसका एक नुकसान मुझे आज सुबह उठाना पड़ा है when my son told me he was about to graduate from LUMS that instead of working for any big multinational or a big bank, he had four different offers with him. So he's chosen to go and work for a small private equity firm because he's so keenly interested in entrepreneurship. It's also a reflection of economy mein changes kis tarike se aa rahi hain. Jab hum graduate karte the, aaj se long, long time. When did I graduate? 1984. So 33 saal pehle, when I graduated from IBA, कोई क्वेश्चन ही नहीं होता था कि कोई अपने बिजनेस के बारे में सोचे. एवरीबडी वाज फोकस्ड ऑन ट्राइंग टू गेट अ गुड जॉब एंड थिंग्स स्टार्टेड चेंजिंग लेट 80s अर्ली 90s. हमने पहली दफ़ा देखा कि प्रोफेशनल यूनिवर्सिटी से लोग निकल के दे वर गेटिंग इंटरेस्टेड इन एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप. अदरवाइज एंटरप्रेन्योर वही बनता था जिसके फैमिली ट्रेडिशन होती थी, बिजनेस करते हैं, वालिद साहब के बिजनेस के अंदर आप चले गए या कोई नया बिजनेस शुरू किया. मोस्टली वालिद साहब का बिजनेस, समटाइम न्यू बिजनेस, बट ओनली दोज पीपल हु केम फ्रॉम फैमिलीज हु वर इनटू बिजनेस. दिस कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ प्रोफेशनल्स हु हैड नो फैमिली बैकग्राउंड इन बिजनेस स्टार्टिंग टू एक्सपेरिमेंट एंड स्टार्टिंग टू स्टार्ट देयर ओन बिजनेसेस इज अ रिलेटिवली न्यू फिनोमेना इन पाकिस्तान. नाउ अब जहाँ पर हम खड़े हुए हैं, इट्स वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग. लेट मी डू एन एक्सपेरिमेंट हियर. ये मैं का यूनिवर्सिटीज में जाता हूँ तो मैं पूछता हूँ, आप में से कितने लोग जो हैं जब ग्रेजुएट करेंगे तो आपकी फर्स्ट चॉइस जो है वो ये होगी कि आप अपना कोई अपना बिजनेस शुरू करें. वाओ, ओके, दिस इज मोर देन इवन यूजुअल. वरना कम से कम 1/3 हैंड्स गो अप. नाउ एवरीबडी मे नॉट बी सक्सेसफुल इन अचीविंग दिस ड्रीम बट इट शोज ए शिफ्ट इन द माइंड. एंड बड़ी चेंजेस जो है हमेशा सबसे पहले होती ही ऐसी हैं. द चेंजेस इन एटीट्यूड्स विच कम इन एंड देन फॉलो द रिजल्ट्स विच एवरीबडी सीज एंड दिस इज अ फैंटास्टिक साइन. ये बड़ी ज़बरदस्त एक खुशाइन चीज़ है पाकिस्तान के लिए कि लोग जो हैं, नौजवान जो नस्ल है वो इट इज़ फीलिंग कॉन्फिडेंट, इट इज़ फीलिंग दैट दे हैव द कैपेसिटी टू गो आउट एंड डू समथिंग ऑन देयर ओन. सो क्वेश्चन देन बिकम्स कि क्या किया जाए और किस तरीके से अप्रोच किया जाए. मोटी मोटी दो तीन चीज़ें विच आई वुड लाइक टू शेयर विद यू एंड देन आई डोंट नो आपका फॉर्मेट क्या है. इफ़ यू वांट टू हैव अ क्यू एंड ए आफ्टर दैट, इज दैट सो आई प्रेफर टू कीप माय इनिशियल टॉक रिलेटिवली शॉर्ट सो दैट देयर इज मोर क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर. सबसे पहले तो जो ओवरऑल एक इकोनॉमिक लैंडस्केप अगर हम देखेंगे ना, तो एग्रीकल्चर पाकिस्तान के अंदर मोस्टली जो है वो unorganized, informal tarike se ki jati hai. And people have not really gone, you don't hear about a lot of entrepreneurs, professional, young, educated people who are going into agriculture, unless, as I said, ki family ka go hai. But it's actually a space where there is tremendous opportunity. Because Pakistani agriculture is so informal, so unstructured, productivity is extremely low, market linkages are extremely poor. So as a result of all this, your ability to excel is very high. Your ability to compete and win is very, very high. We have just a handful of examples, bahut kam examples hain, but there are some examples. And I'll use his example not because he belongs to the same political party as I am, but probably because he's the most high-profile case of this success. Professional background se aaya, and started, went into farming. Didn't know farming. Simply was an educated person. North Carolina se MBA kiya hua tha. Approached it professionally and learned to do very, very high productivity agriculture, and from there went on into agro-based industry as well. And that's Jahangir Tareem. So there, he's a very good example of the opportunities that can be created for educated people, even those who do not have a past background in agriculture. Or aap mein se agar kisi ki family jo hai, wo agriculture ke andar hai, dairy and livestock ke andar opportunities hai, fruits, vegetables, horticulture, these are all high value agriculture jisko hum kehte hai. Large scale, field irrigated agriculture is probably not where the biggest opportunities lie for entrepreneurs, for individuals like you. Wahan pe phir wo scale ki baat aati hai, large capital ki baat aati hai. So these are some of the things, simple cheez Pakistan ke andar aapne bahut suna hoga, pani ka bahut masla hai, bahut shor hota hai Pakistan mein ki pani ki kami hoti ho rahi hai, aur drought aa raha hai Pakistan mein, aur Pakistan jo hai water scarce country ban gaya hai. You want to know something remarkable? Pakistan mein takriban 3/4 of all water is consumed in agriculture. So primarily it's agriculture where water, drinking water jo logon ke peene ka pani hai, it's a very, very tiny fraction of the total water consumption that we have. You know, the biggest problem in Pakistan in agriculture is not shortage of water. The biggest problem in Pakistan is over irrigation of field crops. Jitna pani istemal karna chahiye, usse zyada istemal ho raha hai. And that is why if you go to a place like Israel, jahan barren desert ke andar unhone drip irrigation karke, green apni wo karke, tunnel farming karke, they've got productivity which is far higher than Pakistan, jahan ke andar hamari natural endowments Allah Taala ne hame jo di hai, jo mausam diya hai, jo zameen diya hai, jis tarah ki pani availability hai, we should be very, very far ahead of them. But simply by the deployment of technology. So without going into much more detail, so that's one area jo normally jahan nahi baat karte hain, that's something you should think about. Even in Islamabad, yahan pe baith ke aapke, you can do high value added agriculture. So that's an area that you should explore. Second area jo jahan pe exploration aajkal bahut mushkil hui bhi, and that is one of the fundamental problems of Pakistan's economy, and that's manufacturing. Manufacturing is really, really tough in Pakistan right now. And there are multiple reasons for that. One reason is quite simply this: manufacturing hoti kya? You take raw material, you convert it, you process it, you convert it into finished goods, and then you go and sell it to consumers. The problem in Pakistan is ki ye jo pehla hi process yahan pe hai, raw material availability to betahasha hai. You got all kinds of minerals available in Pakistan. Agriculture, this is one of the great agricultural basins of the world. Dunya ki history aapko batati hai ki one of the great agricultural basins of the world. So raw material is not the issue. Jab aap processing ke upar aate ho, jo skill sets hain aapki, Air University jaisi education jo hai, wo pure Pakistan ke hum 1% ko bhi nahi de rahe. The vast majority of our workforce is walking out with either no education, that's almost 40% of Pakistan, no education, or with extremely low level of skills in their hands. So duniya jo hai wo to ab ek mandi ban gayi hai. The world is no longer ye wo wali jagah nahi hai aaj se jo 30 saal pehle 25-30 saal pehle hoti thi. Aap high tariff walls khadi karein, uske piche aap apni local industry develop kar dein, jab industry develop ho jaye to then you bring the walls down and then you compete with the world. Pakistan ki bari jab tak aayi, hamare paas opportunity thi, hum to 1960s mein ye jo Asian boom aaya, hum inse aage the. Except for Japan, Japan to khair ek industrial power thi even Second World War ke andar, But other than that, Pakistan was ahead of everybody else. Every other country in Asia, Pakistan was ahead of them in the race. But uske baad we lost our way, and as a result, ab jo hum situation face kar rahe hain, hamare paas ye opportunity nahi hai ki wo purana model of creating these barriers. So wo opportunity hamare paas khatam ho gayi, and therefore from day one we now have to compete with the rest of the world. Aapne muqabla karna hai apne mulk ke andar bhi, because the rest of the world is sending goods into your country, and aapne zahir hai Pakistan jo hai wo total $300 billion ki economy hai. Duniya is waqt takriban $70 trillion ki economy hai. So if you want to be really successful, it's a $70 trillion market that you want to crack. But even for this $300 billion market, the rest of the world and China, which is the manufacturing capital of the world, is right next door to us. Aur hamari connectivity China ke sath behtar hone ja rahi hai. Far better road networks, rail network improve hone ja raha hai through CPEC, and as a result opportunity create ho rahi hai, but it's also going to make it even easier for the Chinese products to come into the Pakistani market. So with the skill sets that we have, our workers simply do not produce goods of a quality and at a price which can compete with the rest of the world. So manufacturing ke andar, that's one aspect of it. Then obviously there are the energy issues Pakistan mein, ya energy availability ke issues hai, shortages hai. Yeah, jahan pe hai bhi, pure region ke andar is waqt we have the highest electricity rates in the world, the highest gas rates, not in the world, in the region. The highest electricity rates, the highest gas prices. So your input costs are very, very high. So that's an area you should be very, that doesn't mean ke koi opportunity nahi hai manufacturing ke andar. There are opportunities, but you have to be very, very careful in which opportunity you select. And you have to essentially come up into a domain where one of two conditions exist. Either you're shielded from global competition, which as I said, there are remarkably few things left jahan pe you're shielded from global competition, or Pakistan has an exceptional edge in terms of indigenous availability of raw material or something. Wo bhi uski importance jo hai wo it's dramatically reduced. Ab ye surat hal isko dekhe na ki Pakistan jo hai wo cotton ka itna bada producer hai. Bangladesh ek tanka nahi cotton ka grow karta. Bangladesh ki value added export jo hai wo Pakistan se 4 guna zyada hai. The third area, which is the biggest sector of the economy, is service. And that's an area jahan pe there is phenomenal opportunity available. Virtually every area of service that you'll pick up, you'll find opportunities. And the kind of businesses that can be created from that, mere khayal mein education se behtar uski misal hi nahi hai. What started off with one city school and one Beacon House school have transformed into multi-billion rupee corporations. The amount of opportunity which was available, and they were just the forerunners, or uske baad to Punjab group of colleges and so on and so forth. Chains after chains, Roots in Islamabad has done exceptionally well. Market ke andar opportunity thi, state failure tha, state was not being able to meet its constitutional requirements or constitutional obligations, and therefore that opportunity was exploited by the private sector. And ek school kiraye pe leke banane mein there isn't a lot of capital involved, it just needed somebody who had the ability to think ke opportunity ka kya ho sakta. So it's an excellent example of the kind of opportunity that can be created. And main end mein is pe close isi karunga, ek basic growth, ek generic definition dunga of what would be the best kind of business to go into. Is waqt the next big opportunity which is sitting there is healthcare. Healthcare mein is waqt wahi situation hai jo education ke andar thi, and nobody has really come up with a scalable model of healthcare. It could be a franchise based model, it could take some other form, but there is tremendous opportunity available in healthcare. Again, falls in the service sector. Mid size town ke andar hospitality services chote, particularly Punjab ke jo, because there's a lot of intercity travel in Punjab, middle class population hai, purchasing power wale log hai, sales officers and traders, businessmen, etc., farmers are moving back and forth, and jo mid tier hotel industry hai wo extremely weak hai. That's another great opportunity available here. Entertainment. Pakistan is an entertainment starved country, and therefore there is phenomenal, it's almost unlimited opportunity in entertainment in Pakistan. And again, there are many different, obviously I don't have the time to go into many too much detail, but there are many different aspects of these industries, and there are things that you can do literally with no capital in your pocket, or very, very little capital in your pocket, which can start to feed into this value chain, and then you start growing. Many other examples. Tourism is exploding. Domestic tourism is exploding in Pakistan. Jahan pe گلگل بلتستان میں آج سے دو سال پہلے 300,000 ٹورسٹ گیا تھا وہاں پچھلے سال جو ہے دے کراسڈ 1,000,000 کا مارک وی ور سٹنگ ود دا گلگت بلتستان چیف منسٹر سی پیک کی کانفرنس ہو رہی تھی اس کے لیے ہم لوگ گئے ہوئے تھے اینڈ ہی ٹولڈ اس کہ جی پہلے تو دے رین آؤٹ آف ہوٹل رومس اس کے بعد ایکچولی رین شارٹ آف پیٹرول اتنی گاڑیاں آ گئی تھیں وہاں پر سو دس از اندر فنامنل اپرچونیٹی ٹوریزم کے اندر اٹس اے گروتھ انڈسٹری اور ابھی آپ دیکھ رہے ہیں کنسٹرین ڈیمانڈ بیکاز فیسلٹیز وغیرہ ایگزسٹ نہیں کرتی ہیں بیکاز نو بڈی از ڈن اے ریئل مارکیٹنگ جاب آف پروموٹنگ ٹوریزم تو ابھی جو آپ کو ڈیمانڈ نظر آ رہی ہے وچ از آلریڈی فینٹاسٹک اینڈ گروئنگ سو ریپڈلی از ایکچولی ناٹ ڈیمونسٹریٹو آف واٹ از پاسبل جب ایکچوئل کوئی مارکیٹنگ کرے گا اینڈ صحیح فیسلٹیز بنیں گی یو سی ہاؤ دس اپرچونیٹی ول ایکسپلور سو دیز آر سم آف دا سروسز ڈومین از ویئر دا لارجسٹ نمبر آف اپرچونیٹیز لائی بٹ جسٹ ٹو ایز آئی سیڈ آئی ڈونٹ وانٹ ٹو اسپیک ٹو لانگ سو آئی جسٹ گیو یو اے جنریک ڈیفینیشن کہ اپرچونیٹیز جو آپ نے دیکھنی ہے کس نیچر کی اپرچونیٹی از واٹ یو شوڈ لک بی لکنگ ایٹ ناٹ اسپیسیفکلی نہیں کیا آپ نے کون سا بزنس کرنا ہے بٹ نیچر آف اپرچونیٹی کیا ہونی چاہیے آئیڈیل بزنس فار سم بڈی اینڈ آئی ازیوم دیٹ موسٹ پیپل ان دس روم آر بیٹر آف دین آئی واز وین آئی واز یور ایج بٹ ناٹ اے ہیل آف اے لاٹ بیٹر آف میں تو ریٹائرڈ جنرل کا بیٹا تھا تو میں تو ماں سے میں نے ادھار لیا تھا 30,000 روپے 60,000 روپے کی سوزوکی گاڑی خریدنے کے لیے ہوپ فلی موسٹ آف یو آر سلائٹلی بیٹر آف ان دیٹ بٹ یو ڈونٹ ہیو ڈیپ پاکٹس یو ڈونٹ ہیو لارج اماؤنٹس آف کیپٹل اویلیبل ٹو یو گیون دیٹ دی آئیڈیل بزنس دیٹ یو گیٹنگ ان ٹو از سم تھنگ وچ از اسمال ٹو بگن ود بٹ از اے بزنس وچ از اسکیلیبل میں نے جیسے آپ کو ایگزامپل دی تھی نا سٹی اسکول کی The first business was very small. کیا capital cost آئی ہوگی essentially جو تھوڑا بہت میں نے analysis کیا تھا they were probably able to start that business literally with a few thousand rupees کی investment to begin with because جو انہوں نے انیشیل انویسٹمنٹ کرنی ہوتی ہے فرنیچر میں اور جو ایڈوانس رینٹ دینا پڑا ہوگا وہ تو جو ان کی پہلا بیچ آیا گا اس کی جو ڈپازٹ لیتے ہیں اسکول کا اور وہ 3 مہینے کی ایڈوانس فیس وہ اس سے مور اور لیس واش ہو گیا ہوگا بٹ دیٹ بزنس واز اے اسکیلیبل بزنس بیکاز وہ جا رہے تھے ایک اسکول کھولنے کے لیے اینڈ مے بی اس کے اندر 400 بچے تھے بٹ پاکستان کے اندر 4 کروڑ بچے تھے جن کو تعلیم جو ہے وہ اس کوالٹی کی نہیں مل رہی تھی جو وہ چاہتے ہیں آبویسلی ڈفرنٹ پرائز پوائنٹ ڈفرنٹ لیولز آف مارکیٹ سائز ول ایمرج سو یو آر لوکنگ ایٹ اے بزنس وچ از ویئر یو کین اسٹارٹ اسمال لائک فار ایگزامپل یو کینٹ سیٹ اپ اے پیٹرو کیمیکل ریفائننگ کمپلیکس ایز اے اسمال پروجیکٹ آپ وہ شروع ہی کریں گے آپ چھوٹا بھی کریں گے تو آپ یو ٹاکنگ اباؤٹ $700 million بٹ یو کین اسٹارٹ اے اسکول وتھ ویری ویری لٹل کیپٹل بٹ اٹ ہیز ٹو بی اے بزنس وچ از اسکیلیبل یہ چیز یہ بہت غلطی کرتے ہیں لوگ پیپل ڈونٹ لک اہیڈ دے لک ایٹ دس اینڈ مے بی ایک اسکول بہت اگین یوزنگ دا ایگزامپل آف اسکول مے بی بہت سکسیزفل ہو جاتا لیکن اگر وہ ایک ہی اسکول سکسیزفل ہوتا اس میں اسکیلیبلٹی کہاں سے آ رہی تھی دو چیزوں سے آ رہی تھی ایک تو اسکیلیبلٹی آ رہی تھی سائز آف دا مارکیٹ جو ان میٹ ڈیمانڈ تھی مارکیٹ کے اندر اٹ واز ہیوج And the second part which was making it scalable was the ability to create a business model which is franchising where you could really scale it up without and at a very rapid pace without deploying a lot of capital. So, ye do cheezein jo hain wo agar aap apne zehen mein rakhein and the last part ideally it's a business that you are it's a business which is about a good or a service that you're passionate about. جو سکسیس آپ کو ملتی ہے فار تھنگز وچ آر پیشنیٹ اباؤٹ آئی ٹی انڈسٹری کو کوئی فالو کرتا ہے یہاں پہ بچے آپ نے جو بڑے نام ہیں انڈسٹری کے اسٹیو جابز ہو گیا یہ زکربرگ اینڈ سو اینڈ سو فورتھ یو فالو دیئر اسٹوریز اینڈ یو ول فائنڈ آؤٹ دیٹ ان 95% آف دا کیسز دی اونلی ایکسیپشن ٹو دس ان دا بگ ونز دیٹ آئی ایم اویئر آف از بل گیٹس بل گیٹس کیم فرام اے ویری کمرشل مائنڈ سیٹ Almost all other guys were just passionate about technology. And because they were so passionate about technology, they believed in it so much that they were able to do things. That resulted in two things. One, it made them innovate. It made them do things which normally were not being done because they were so passionately involved in it. And second, and that's extremely important in becoming an entrepreneur, and remember that, it allowed them to go through the difficult phase without losing faith جو آپ کو فنکشنل چیزیں آپ کو سب یونیورسٹی پڑھا دے گی اور آپ اچھے کسی جگہ پہ کام کرنے جائیں گے تو آپ سیکھ جائیں گے The real challenge in being a successful entrepreneur, as is in doing anything where you have to take control of your own destiny, is this emotional makeup, this inner strength, which gives you the self-belief that jo main kaam karne ja raha hu, this is something, A, that it's something worth fighting for, it's something worth pursuing, and I have faith that I can do it. That inner faith is what will help you go through the, because trust me, there will be difficult times. Even if you start off on day one as being extremely successful, as you try and grow, you'll hit a rough patch. That's just the dynamics of how these things go. So you will at that point be tested, and if what you're doing you're really passionate about, agar passionate hai iska matlab aap uske bare mein padhte bhi honge, aapko history bhi pata hogi, aapko uski positives negatives bhi pata honge, you would be emotionally engaged, and it will help you deal with that difficult emotional phase. And after that, inshallah ta'ala, once you become successes, phir aap bhi kisi seminar mein khade hoke, you'll be talking about how to pursue a career in entrepreneurship.
Assalamu alaikum, sir. Thank you so much for gracing us with your time. Sir, my question basically arised from joint venture, if you heard about it. Renault is entering the market of Pakistan, Renault Motors. They are assisted by Nishat Lenin. They are doing a joint venture. So, sir, my question is that a very well-formed company, an international company, needs a local company to assist them in entering a market, while we are just youngsters, young blood entering to the market. So don't you think that the aspects of Pakistani market are a bit not too easy to get in? Don't you think that we need assist some government programs just to...
Got it.
Main samajh gaya. Aapka samajh gaya question, and I can relate to it directly, because jaise wo intro ke andar bata rahe the, मैं 1997 में चीफ एग्जीक्यूटिव ऑफिसर बना था इंग्रो असाई पॉलीमर कंपनी लिमिटेड का, एंड इट वाज अ जॉइंट वेंचर बिटवीन इंग्रो एंड असाई ग्लास एंड मित्सुबिशी ऑफ जापान. एंड उससे पहले वन ईयर बिफोर दैट आई हैड लेड द डेवलपमेंट फ्रॉम द इंग्रो साइड ऑफ अ प्रोजेक्ट विच बिकेम अ जॉइंट वेंचर बिटवीन इंग्रो एंड रॉयल वोपैक ऑफ नेदरलैंड्स. एंड सो आई डायरेक्टली वर्कड ऑन निगोशिएटेड एंड रन जॉइंट वेंचर, सो आई नो एग्जैक्टली क्या ड्राइविंग फोर्स होता है वहाँ से. You're absolutely right के पाकिस्तानी market के अंदर even when a world class company is coming here, तो एक local domain knowledge है, उस domain knowledge की वजह से they're interested. Another example of that is Friesland Campina has just bought into Engro Foods, and they've bought 51% equity there in Engro Foods. Engro is the local partner there right now. So yes, there are domain knowledge issues, but आपके पास तो वो domain knowledge available है ना. And we are not talking of businesses. That's why I was talking to your mind. I don't want to, that's why I didn't give examples of Engro Vopak and Engro Polymer and all these, because those are big ventures. Inshallah, you'll get there one day, but those are big ventures. Hum toh keh rahe hain ki opportunity aapko identify wo karni hai, which is relatively small in size, at least as a starting point, and ideally, jaise maine kaha ki wo scalable opportunity hai. Another example of scalable opportunity is ek pharmacy aap khole, aap successful hoge, brand name, you can franchise and you can have thousands of pharmacies all over Pakistan, and people trust that brand. Ki basic kya hoti hai? Brand is a promise, right? So jitna strong wo promise ke upar belief hoga logon ka, utna brand successful hota hai. So anything which can be branded is scalable by definition. So that's the bag. Just because unko aane ke liye Nishad ki help ki zarurat hai, doesn't mean ki aap business nahi kar sakte. Engro Foods ki usne baat kar di thi, wo jo pichla question tha usse main relate karke ke ye jo aate hain muqabla karne ke liye, actually as a local player, ye mera hamesha se strong believe raha tha ki yaar wo meri pitch pe khelne ke liye aa raha hai, Pakistan aa raha hai na, mere se muqabla karne ke liye aa raha hai, so I should be able to take on the best in the world. Engro Food जब हमने लॉन्च किया था, लिक्विड मिल्क बिजनेस की कैटेगरी के अंदर हम जा रहे थे. नेस्ले दुनिया की सबसे बड़ी फूड कंपनी है, और नेस्ले का 45% मार्केट शेयर था, और वो 21 साल से मार्केट के अंदर थे. एंग्रो ने कभी FMCG बिजनेस नहीं किया था, बट बिकॉज वी हैड आर डेस्टिनी इन आर ओन कंट्रोल, वी हैड अ ब्रांड नेम थ्रू विच वी कुड पिक अप द बेस्ट टीम इन पाकिस्तान, वी कुड गिव देम समथिंग विच MNC can't give, which is belief in Pakistan, and say we'll take risk because we believe in Pakistan. Jis waqt board approval maine liya tha na, to I had said ki 5 saal ke andar Engro will be the market leader in this thing, aur wo log bole pagal ho gaye, you're taking on the biggest food company in the world. 3 months, 10 months ke baad, Engro Foods was the market leader that beaten Nestle, and they're still the market leader.
Assalamu alaikum, sir. My question is that ke, jo young entrepreneurs hain, jinki age 20 to 25 hai, wo jab kaam kar rahe hain to unko security issues aate hain Pakistan mein. To us bare mein aap kya kehna chahenge?
Security as in financial security or physical security?
Jab wo kuch earn kar rahe hain, jo bhi unko profit aa raha hai, uski pushkar shuru ho jati hai, physical security bhi beech mein aa jati hai. Ye factor bhi hai.
Acha, physical security to mulk mein halaat pichle 3 saal mein bahut behtar hue hain. اور اسلام آباد میں ریلیٹیولی ایک احساس سے تحفظ ویسے بھی زیادہ ہے. ایک بڑے شہر دنیا میں جو ہوتے ہیں وہاں پہ کرائم ہوتا ہے اس طریقے سے, پاکستان کے شہروں کے اندر بھی کرائم ہے, لیکن کچھ عرصہ ایسا آیا تھا جہاں واقعی میں حالات اتنے خراب ہو گئے تھے کہ فزیکل سیکیورٹی ہیڈ بیکم اے بگ امپیڈیمنٹ. اور جو ریزنز دیے جاتے تھے ہمارے انویسٹمنٹ ملک کے اندر کیوں گر گئی ہے, اس میں سے ایک وجہ یہ بھی تھی. لیکن اب الحمدللہ حالات بہتر ہیں. ایز اے سیڈ, اسلام آباد کے اندر تو آپ رات کو بھی نکلتے ہیں تو آپ محفوظ ہوتے ہیں. جہاں تک فائنینشیل اس کی بات ہے, وہ صرف ینگ کا نہیں ہے, دیر از اے فنڈامنٹل پرابلم رائٹ ناؤ. ہو کیا رہا ہے کہ اگر آپ ٹھیک طریقے سے کام کرنا چاہتے ہیں, if you want to do everything which is documented, you want to pay your taxes, you want to be a filer with FBR, aap system ke andar hain, system aapko discourage karta hai, system aapko punish karta hai for being honest. That's an absolute fact, and that's one of the major impediments to professionals becoming entrepreneurs. Because jab main job karne jata hu to chalo yaar meri neat clean job hai, subah gaya daftar, shaam ko main wapas aa gaya, I don't have to face this harassment, I don't have to face a situation جہاں یا میرا بزنس چلا جائے گا یا میرا ویلیو سسٹم مجھے کمپرومائز کرنا پڑے گا. سو دیٹ پارٹ دیٹ یو ریزنگ از اے ویری ویری امپورٹنٹ پوائنٹ. اٹس انفارچونیٹلی اے ریالٹی, دیٹ از دا فیکٹ. بٹ اگین میں کہوں گا, اسی سسٹم کے اندر رہتے ہوئے بھی لوگ ان کنسٹرینٹس کے ساتھ رہتے ہوئے بھی اپرچونیٹی, کیونکہ اس ملک میں بے تحاشا ہے, سو یو ول سی مینی مینی ایگزامپلز. آپ کو یوتھ کے اندر بھی ایگزامپلز ملیں گی آف پیپل ہو ڈن ویری ویل فار دیم سیلز اینڈ بیکم ویری سکسیزفل. بٹ یہ میں ایک چیز آپ کو بتا دوں, ایک ڈائریکٹ کوریلیشن, جو آپٹیمسٹکلی سوچتے ہیں, جو سوچتے ہیں کہ اچھا ہوگا, دے ول آلویز ٹینڈ ٹو بی مور سکسیزفل دین دوز ہو سے کہ کیا خراب ہو جائے گا. سوال یہ ہے کہ سی پے کے جو تھریٹ والے اسپیکٹ جو میں نے ریفر کیا تھا, تو اس کے اوپر تھوڑا سا اور الیبوریٹ کریں. دیکھیں, سی پے کے اندر ہو کیا رہا ہے. پہلی بات تو لیٹس اسٹارٹ ود دا باٹم لائن. سی پے ایک اچھی چیز ہے پاکستان کے لیے, اچھا ہو رہا ہے. پاکستان میں انفراسٹرکچر کی شدید کمی ہے, اور انفراسٹرکچر پروجیکٹس کی فائنینسنگ کی اویلیبلٹی کے ایشو تھے, وہ فائنینسنگ آپ کو مل گئی ہے اور اس سے ہمارا انفراسٹرکچر ڈیولپ ہو رہا ہے. دیٹس اے گڈ تھنگ وچ از ہیپننگ. بٹ فار سی پیک ٹو بی سی پیک, اگر ہم یہ کہہ رہے ہیں کہ یہ انفراسٹرکچر فائنینسنگ کی ایک صرف ارینجمنٹ نہیں تھی, یہ واقعی میں چائنا پاکستان اکنامک کوریڈور ہے, دین اس کوریڈور کے لیے, ایز آئی کیپ آن آسکنگ مائی فرینڈ, بڑی دوستی ہے ان سے, پرانی دوستی ہے, احسن اقبال, ان سے میں پوچھتا ہوں کہ یہ آپ خوبصورت مجھے دکھاتے ہو سڑکیں کالے رنگ کی بہترین بلوچستان میں سے گزر رہی ہیں, مجھے یہ بتائیں ان پہ وچ پاکستانی پروڈکٹ ول ٹریول ان ٹو وچ چائنیز مارکیٹ, ہو ول پروڈیوس دیز, اینڈ ویئر ول دیز پروڈکٹس بی پروڈیوسڈ. اینڈ ان سوالات کے جواب ابھی تک ہمارے پاس نہیں ہیں. پاکستان نے ابھی تک تھنکنگ ہی نہیں کی تھی, اب وہ تھنکنگ شروع ہو رہی ہے. So as a result, the risk that we are running, ایک تو جو پہلے فیز کے اندر ہی آپ نے دیکھ لیا, بیکاز آپ پریپیئر نہیں تھے, بیکاز آپ گیم پلان کے ساتھ نہیں گئے, ہوا یہ کہ لگ بھگ $50 billion کی انویسٹمنٹ ہو رہی ہے, اور اس کے اندر پاکستانی انڈسٹری کا جو حصہ ہے وہ صفر کے قریب ہے, ایکسیپٹ فار سم روڈ پروجیکٹس جہاں پہ ہمارا ہے, بٹ دا پاور پلانٹس, ایوری تھنگ از امپورٹنٹ, ایوری تھنگ. The Chinese, میں نے تو بہت کام کیا, ہماری ایک اسٹریٹجک ریلیشن شپ تھی لارجسٹ چائنیز انجینئرنگ کمپنی کے ساتھ اوور 25 years, اور ہمارے جتنے بڑے پروجیکٹس ہیں وہ چائنیز کے ساتھ ہوئے ہیں. سو آئی نو, آئی واز ٹیلنگ مشاہد حسین سید جو پارلیمنٹری کمیٹی کے ہیڈ ہیں سی پیک کے, کہ چائنیز تو اپنا کک بھی ساتھ لاتے ہیں, ٹرانسلیٹر ساتھ آتا ہے, ڈاکٹر ساتھ آتا ہے, سو دے آر سیلف کنٹینڈ کمیونٹی. سو وہ میں گلگت بلتستان کا جو ذکر کر رہا تھا, وہاں پہ گئے, وہ چائنیز سے بات ہو رہی تھی, ان کا پروجیکٹ مینیجر تھا, مشاہد آسکڈ ہم جسے کہ تم کھانے کے لیے کیا کرتے ہو, اس نے کہا ہم اپنے ساتھ اپنے کک لے کے آئے ہوئے ہیں. تو مشاہد نے مجھے آنکھ ماری, پھر دینی سے, اچھا تم اگر کوئی بیمار ہو جائے تو کوئی فیسلٹی والا ہے, اس نے کہا ہم ڈاکٹر ساتھ لے کے آئے ہوئے ہیں, وچ از فینٹاسٹک. وہ کام تو ہو گیا, بٹ heavy electrical complex, heavy mechanical complex, Pakistan machine tool factory, steel mill. ये मैं state-owned इदारों की बात कर रहा हूँ जो हम उठा सकते थे through a better strategic plan. उस $50 billion का अगर हम 5% इंजीनियरिंग काम यहाँ पे ले लेते तो ये सारे इदारे ट्रांसफॉर्म हो जाते. I was not trying to imitate a very popular and successful politician. This was only a coincidence. Achha. So that we have already seen. So the risk is that when the infrastructure improves, agar aapka koi game plan nahi hai, agar aap competitive nahi hai, to all you are doing it, making it easier for others to, which is not an argument to say that aapko infrastructure nahi mil karna chahiye, bilkul karna chahiye. Lekin uska fayda uthane ke liye, it's extremely urgent. Aur iske andar three-way partnership ki zarurat hai. Hamein the government and the political system, National Assembly Standing Committees dwara jo hain, ya CPEC ki ek parliamentary committee bani bhi hai, wo, and the government is one end, industry is a second end, and academia needs to be involved. We have not involved, engaged academia at all, ke humari indigenous kya capabilities ho sakti hain, what can we graft on top of this opportunity. So it's that risk that I was talking about, ke agar goods wahan se aa rahi hain, and mostly they're flowing through Gwadar, for export, but yahan se guzar hi rahi hai to itni badi market hai yaar, $300 billion ki China Afghan transit trade ke sath dekhe na kya hota hai hamare sath.
Thank you Mr. Asad Umar for a very inspiring lecture. So
students should know that so the lunch speaker told us to be a successful entrepreneur you need to have motivation, you need to have competency, you need to have a viable plan, and above all you need to be a risk taker, and you need to have the motivation to fight competition. Thank you for being here.